för oss som astronomer eller som står på jorden, vi kan liksom inte göra experiment i universum. Det enda vi kan göra är att vi kan sitta här och vi kan försöka dra slutsatser av det ljus som når oss. Och det är lite så hela vår världsbild har byggts upp under 1000 år.
Om allting rör sig ifrån oss, och det finns ingenstans i universum där det finns någon punkt som det utgår ifrån. Det finns inte heller.
Du kan svara på ett annat sätt. Varje punkt i universum är den punkten.
Oj, okay. Det var intressant.
Så att hela universum har från början rymts i en punkt. Och det kan se det i den här grafen. Det här är universum, här är alla galaxerna. Om vi nu krymper universum så kommer alla de här punkterna så småningom rymmas i en punkt. Och det är det vi kallar för Big Bang.
This dark matter is none of these particles. Because the theory that describes all of these particles that I told you we've seen in the last 60 years it works, it doesn't predict any particle like that. So we need to add a piece to our model to describe this new particle that we know it's there because these things hold together, so there is a mass that is missing. But it cannot be one of these particles described by the standard model.
Och det är naturligtvis så att vakuum är någonting som finns i universum. Det är alltså det grunden som vi står på, allt som existerar i någonting. Det här i någonting, det är tomrummet.
You keep asking us what do you want? And I want to ask you, well, what do you want? What are your expectations?
Well, maybe one difference is that as artists, when you create something, you share that with many other people. And as scientists, a lot of what we do is not shared, or we don't have many occasions to share it. So I think already the sharing of what we do to people who are receptive to that is giving us something.
We very seldom speak about this aspect in science, even though it is essential. It's never talked about among scientists, so I think it can be very important for us to have other partners to talk about creativity, and we can come back to keep that when we go back to our everyday work.
Is the artist judging himself or herself in first place?
Yeah.
Because I think that for us it's the same.
Yeah.
Yeah. We are thinking, okay, this calculation is very neat or not.
Mm-hmm.
But in the end, there is someone else that is judging what we have done. For example, when we publish something, we can't say, okay, the paper is done, because there is a referee process always.
But wait, that's just mechanics of your work. Eventually, your thing is correct if nature proves to behave that way.
Yeah.
It's like art is, because everybody can look at a piece of art, it's like art is for everyone. And I think art is for everyone. I think also astronomy is for everyone, but everybody can't understand it. I mean, but there could be a lot of people that aren't physicists or particle physicists, but still can have an appreciation. I mean, it's not, you don't have a monopoly on space. I mean, I don't understand, but I can still, we're all nature. We're all a part of the cosmos. And in a way, and you are looking at certain things that you know a lot about. And I think artists, maybe it's the same way. We're looking at things, and maybe that's the inner cosmos or something. Mm. But we're expressing it. To do something new is really, it's built on everything you've ever seen, everything you've ever heard, everything you've ever thought.
Too high.
Don't hold it too much like this.
Okay,
it has
okay.
to be at an angle.
Okay.
Good. You're really good. Fantastic.
But that's so. Usually, most galaxies have a big black hole in the center. So that you can really like think of that as a active galactic nuclei or quasar or something.
Because you mean it's not black in the center? I was thinking of it as the galaxies going into it.
Right.
That it's a beginning before the black hole, you know, it's like the formation of a black hole. I have this idea.
What I see, that's with what I know about black holes, what I see there is just the black hole is here. And
yes.
You cannot even see it. And this is all the material which is
being sucked into it.
Exactly, and starts.
Now, can it be sucked in on both sides? That I maybe made a mistake.
No, actually, as a matter of fact, it starts spherically, but eventually you will have a disk.
Okay.
Because it's easier, when stuff starts whirling, it produces a disk.
Yeah,
okay.
It's black hole accretion.
And
so I can call it a black hole, right?
Indeed, yeah.
Hejsan och välkomna till min ateljé i Uppsala, Rackarbacken är den på. Det här är mina arbetsytor då, där jag har också hängt upp lite konst från olika epoker av mitt liv. Just nu är det ju aktuellt med den här universumutställningen och jag har blivit ombedd att nöja mig med att prata om den, inte om massa annat. Och då är det väl inte så jättelätt att koppla över begreppet universum, forskning kring universum till någon form av konstnärligt uttryck. Samtidigt är det det som är en del av det hela, kanske intressantaste inslaget i själva projektet, det här med processen. Hur går man tillväga för att koppla ihop forskning, vetenskap och konst till någonting fruktbart, någonting som verkligen leder till ökad inspiration hos oss människor, eller vad det nu leder till, det vet jag inte. Någon form av kanske ökad kunskap också. Vi kanske kan hjälpa varandra att förstå mer av vissa saker. Egentligen tror jag vetenskapen, ja, om ni tänker i det här termen av process, att kanske släppa loss ytterligare ett snäpp, alltså om jag tänker hur jag jobbar, att man släpper alla hämningar vissa lägen. Nu ska jag inte säga, det kanske är så att vetenskapen, många vetenskapsmän gör det, att man släpper allting, att man låter kaos råda på något sätt. Det är möjligt, men jag tror ju att det kan vara ett sätt att låsa upp sig själv. Man kan ju tänka sig till exempel att vetenskapsmän skulle må bra av att hålla på med konst då. Inte bara som egen terapi, utan som ett sätt att släppa loss grejer. Och egentligen handlar det ju kanske om olika stadier i oss människor. Egentligen är vi ju som mest kreativa innan vi har lärt oss hur saker och ting ska se ut. Till exempel på dagis. Jag tycker att det är en oöverträffad kreativ ålder. Som jag tror att konstnärer eftersträvar många gånger. Jag eftersträvar den definitivt. Och jag tror att många vetenskapsmän borde eftersträva den också. En del kanske gör det väldigt medvetet. Men där är det ju någon form av orädd frihet som råder. Man bara gör. Man håller inte på att analysera sönder saker som man gör sen då. Vilket då blockerar delar av, ska vi säga, den infallsmässiga förmågan.
And this is the model for the bigger work. And this is about actually, the name of it is Il Passaggio. So that means actually that you, also the passage either in through the black hole, or it could be into life, out of life. It could be a passage from one level of understanding to another insight. And what's interesting about this is that you have, before you get through actually in this hole, it's so much struggling, it's so hard physically also. I mean, it's not just to go through here to make the model, but physically when you work with the stone, to go through this hole is extremely painful. Like it is in life, when you have to get another when you're getting to another insight, it's very painful because you have to let go your previous understanding. So this is what this is about. And because it is a process I am through myself now, but it's also very well related to this project. So that's why I picked out this.
We had an idea. Uh-huh. We don't know if you like it. It's Ingvar and Sejun, and we're talking about how to get you kind of going with doing something yourselves, maybe kind of hands-on. So we thought we would leave this with you. And if you could figure out equations or formulas or whatever.
We write actual confessional things or actual things that we really felt when we were writing this paper.
And now we hope that
things
nobody
that maybe you
should not say.
Things that maybe you never told your collaborators.
Can I suggest something?
Yeah.
How was that
really
going
to
share
that?
You
have to say, like, I was severely depressed when
some
I wrote this whole paper.
Well, that's
something.
Not
like,
awareness.
I know. I feel like it's true for
awareness of what?
Of our environment?
Yeah.
But if this is very private and confessional,
yeah,
these are our own inner things which are going around in our head, which maybe in fact keep
right.
us from connecting
yeah.
to other people. Or one of the things that separates us in our own worries. And then this board is more about the arena in which we are connecting.
So this is the thinking process. The thinking process is straight, but it's not only straight, it's open.
Nah, but I like this better.
Emily is very skeptical.
No, I'm not.
Use it flat.
Like this?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This?
Yeah.
Nice.
That's kind of nice because then we're ending the whole board with a question mark.
Yeah. Okay.
Considering that we start reading in the upper left corner, which we assume. I think it's good. Are we happy?
Some 100 years ago, art and science were really integrated. And we have been specialized and drawing apart for so many 100 years. And I think it's a time also that science and art come together, and different sciences and art come together. That was probably the spontaneous feeling I got when I said yes immediately, because I think people are longing for that. And I think we have so much to learn from each other.